Welcome to Mr. Skipper 2017.
Before we introduce you to the men of the hour, it's time to introduce our judges.
Our first judge will be making sure everything adds up, math teacher extraordinaire, Miss Olivia Almeida. First contestant. Derek Bennett, escorted by Audrey Hart.
Thank you, Rex.
I'm just filling in for Mr. Carter. He is at his old high school getting welcomed back. Need my glasses. Derek, Neil, Diamond, Bennett. Derek is an amazing young man. Honestly, I think Derek is Cohasset's best kept secret. And let's keep it that way. Seriously. Do we want people to know, in the outside world, where he's really from? What kind of reputation would that give our fair town? The way I see it, we have a year before he goes away to college. Hopefully we can get him some t-shirts from Scituate, Hingham, Marshfield, Yemen, or someplace where they won't let him back in. But seriously, Derek has a lot of friends in this town and in the building. Not just students, teachers, administrators too. Just last week, Derek was walking down the hallway. And Mr. Willis said, "Hey, when you get to high school, do you want to play basketball?" Let's face it, Derek is our tallest seventh grader. But Derek is growing up fast. Rumor has it he's going to sleepaway camp for lip syncing this summer. He has shown a lot of talent in the competitive karaoke circuit, and he's hanging his hopes on a scholarship for karaoke. Actually, Derek is a young man with 15 seconds of fame. His first 15 seconds came as YouTube sensation. Just Google Cohasset defensive tackle getting pancaked for the Cohasset Skippers. Derek is the total package. Athletics, foreign language, the arts. What hasn't this kid got? Well, he doesn't have a bone in his tongue. Just last week, true story, a classmate bit his tongue and Derek said, "Did it go right through the bone?" I repeat, that is a true story. Mr. Neil Diamond Bennett. And his lovely escort, Audrey Hart. I'm sorry.
Please welcome to the stage, Jack Cunningham, escorted by Marina Longo.
Mr. Nicely himself, Jack Cunningham.
Oh, yeah!
Woo! Thank you. He's looking nicely this evening, I must say. Like a young Mr. Sasso, Jack Cunningham is quite adept at video production. When he's not stalking the halls as nicely, his alter ego, he's in the 143 studio editing videos. Mr. Sasso is rumored to be very envious of his talents. Mr. Nicely, Jack Cunningham.
And next, our next contestant is Connor Curran, escorted by Jenny Wolf.
Hello, smart boy. These are just a few of my thoughts and observations after I saw you hanging out in your usual spot in the park between Tedeschi's and French Memories. Connor's favorite color is camouflage. He even has a special outfit that makes him blend right into the chair in my classroom, so I won't call on him. It's very clever. It actually works so well that when they asked me to roast at tonight's event, I said, "Oh, I never had Connor in class, but I'll take him." And then I went home and I said, "I just had him last semester." I completely forgot. I didn't remember Connor in my class. But I do remember that he came with me and others to Belize 2 years ago on a school trip. Great trip we had, right, Connor? Good times. Well, one day on the trip, for a snack, they passed out boxes of animal crackers. You know, just like to hold us over when we were traveling. Connor took his box and he dumped them out all over the table. And I said, "Connor, what are you doing?" Do you remember what you said? You said, "Well, Mrs. Humphrey, the box says don't eat and if the seal is broken. I'm looking for the seal." That kind of thing was to be expected, though, 2 years ago. After all, Connor was one of the youngest members of our trip. That must explain why the pilots kept giving him those little wings on all the flights. The best part of having Connor on the trip was that he really didn't need a chaperone. that we always knew where he was. One of the best parts of Belize was snorkeling. Wasn't the snorkeling great, Connor? We went out 2 to 3 times a day. We had great guides. They were super knowledgeable. They taught us some amazing things. And each evening we had a meeting with the whole group to talk about what we saw, make plans for the next day. There were always lots of questions. And one night a person asked, when people scuba dive, why do they always fall backwards off the boat? And do you remember what you said then, Connor? He didn't wait for the instructors to answer. He raised his hand and said, I know. He said, it's because if you fall forward, you're still in the boat. You are so smart, Connor. Now we all love getting Mrs. Connolly's weekly updates via Blackboard and email every Friday. There's lots of good stuff in there to keep us all informed. And then, if we want to read the same exact stuff 1 week later, we can just read it in Connor's column. Yes, Connor is an unbelievable reporter. He gets the hard-hitting stuff a week late. In fact, I can't wait to read about this event. What? Sometime in May, maybe? It's gonna be awesome. Connor, I've just now realized that you and I are opposites. You see, I like to try to tell students things they don't know, and you like to retell the things everybody already knows. But seriously though, Connor's column is great. It's called Life at CHS, but it probably should be called Patriots Football Weekly. Because for 21 straight weeks, true fact, you can go back and count them, I just did this afternoon, Connor kept us up to date about the Patriots, Tom Brady's suspension, and the fact that, of course, they won the Super Bowl. In case you hadn't heard and you had no other way to find out, you could read CHS Weekly. The surprise to me was that I had no idea those guys went to our school. And since they all go here, you would think our football team would have won a few more games.
Rotund. And I think I can clear
sure of why he was so big. It was because in utero, he was actually a triplet. But he ate the other two.
He never had a chance.
Anyone ever do a double take when you look at Gavin next to his siblings? Ian is dark and handsome. Ella, dark and beautiful. Gav, white and pasty. Gavin set a school record in soccer this season, and it wasn't in that playoffs where he scored that unbelievable goal. He set a record by being the only player in Cohasset history to score against his brother when he was on the same team. The best part is that he did it in the very first game of the season. Gavin's mother really takes good care of him. Auntie Rhea, I love you. In fact, she got him his first job. Way to go with that initiative, Gav. He was then late for his first day, so they fired him. His mother got right in the car, drove down there, and begged to get his job back. They'll do anything to get you out of the house, Gav, huh? They want him out of the house so bad that his parents called all the colleges he applied to in December to see if he got accepted. They were nervous he wouldn't have a spot until he told them to stop calling and reminded his parents, "If you don't want me, Mom, why would they?" You know what they say, Gav? Money can't buy you love, but it can buy you a 4-year vacation at the University of Tampa. Maybe 5 if you really push it. Go Spartans! People say Gavin can give off a lazy vibe. And I just don't buy it. I've seen him get very excited when plans get canceled. It's true. I know Gavin is very active. He won the Netflix marathon this year, so congrats on that. And he is very organized. His to-do list has one word on it: nothing. And he takes really good care of himself. He's the only person I know who takes a nap before he's tired as a preventative action. I saw it firsthand last year when I had Gavin in AP stats. No, that's not the joke. He was awesome to have in class. If we could have just found a way to have the class without any homework or those pesky things, what do you call them? Oh yeah, tests, he would have had the highest average. Speaking of tests, Gav, is it true that once you fail your driver's test 3 times, they automatically give you the license? I heard that was true, but I wanted to go right to the source. This is true. Gavin's uncle got a solar spotlight to put in his yard to light up his American flag at night. Gav said, "Hey, let me see that box." And he was reading and studying all about it. And then he said, "This would never work. The sun doesn't shine at night." Yeah, that's my godson. I love you, Gavin. Good luck in the contest. Mwah.
Our next contestant, Thomas Durkin, escorted by Aaron Meckel.
A brown-haired Mahoney who dyed his hair to fit in with a more popular family. Don't believe it. He is truly a Durkin. In fact, he's the biggest one, and that's how I tell him apart from the others, because he doesn't have the athletic prowess of his sister Michaela, and he doesn't have the personality of his sister Callie, but, don't let that get in the way of your unbridled admiration for what he brings to school every day. He has perfected the art of Cohasset High School street smarts. He strategically sits in every class next to guys like McHugh and Cohen so he can seem really smart. He immediately owns up to all of his many mistakes and questionable behavior, constantly and consistently. He embodies the classic report card comment, takes responsibility for his actions. In appearance, he is a true gentleman and scholar. He gives these halls grace every day with his presence. We should be thankful. On a questionnaire, he was asked why he talks a big game, and he said, "Well, I beat Mr. Mingles in the mile on Olympic Day, so don't worry, we found the man." Indeed we have, Thomas. Indeed we have.
Please welcome Kyle Ferreira, escorted by Nikki Federley.
That hockey flow. He claims to be extremely for the boys, whatever that means.
Oh, yeah!
I do.
Oh, yeah, baby!
Kyle is very well known for a number of things. One of them being his, not only the flow, but his culinary skills. He's really adept at making popcorn. The Cohasset Fire Department has recently supported that claim. Kyle Ferreira, everyone.
Next, please welcome Patrick Haggerty, escorted by Margot Robbins.
State championships, gone to Harvard, 1,000-point scorers, successful collegiate all-star quarterbacks. That's wrong Harriers. Sorry. Okay. Patrick did go to Harvard. He went on Harvard for Model UN, and he was the most snazzily dressed guy there. He had this, like, sweet pocket watch. It was awesome. It didn't work, but it was spiffy. Looked really good. And okay, he didn't score. Yeah, there it is. Did you fix it? Does it work yet? Okay. He didn't score 1,000 points, but he does have a jump shot that went in once in a JV game. And he's probably not going to be an all-star collegiate quarterback, but you football players out there know that Hags Island is a real thing.
Yeah.
A very real place that you don't want to be stuck on. Unless you do, because I mean, there are worse ways to spend one's time than hanging out with Patrick. I mean, he's a very pleasant young man. Seriously, he can even give you investment advice, according to Mr. Welsh, second only to Jack Fechter's investment advice. Ask him sometime when you're on Hags Island, but maybe don't ask him for advice on your jump shot.
Our next contestant is Matias Loft, escorted by Megan McGilligan.
Denmark, fine words butter no parsnips. Because of that, this contestant deserves no introduction. He's usually more than happy to alert all of us to his presence. Let's face it, when there is a position that no one wants, Matias steps up. And when there is a job that no one wants to do, Matias steps up. And when there's a joke that no one really wants told, out loud and in public, Matias will step up. You know, the Finnish people have, I mean the Danish people have a saying, a blind hen shall find corn. Well, Matias found us and we have found him. As president of this student body, we must remember that wisest of parables made popular on the streets of 18th century Copenhagen. No one knows where the shoe pinches, but he who wears it. By the way, these are all totally legit. Wikipedia, look them up. Matias has recently taken his talents to a fourth grade classroom at the Deer Hill School, and I'm told he fits in quite well there. I believe it. I went down and asked some of those charming young people what they thought of their new classmate. Fresh off the thrill of receiving Valentine's cards, he wrote them personally. And I said, you know, what's it like to have a high school soccer star, a student council president, an AP student among their ranks? And I think my whole experience was summed up by this one young lad. He had these very serious expression on his face, a mature beyond his years little face. And he says, in Denmark, when the day blows half a pelican, best not have a cow on the ice. Wise words, kids. Wise words.
Next, please welcome Maxwell Yamashina, escorted by Charlotte Morrison.
Bonjour, I'm Mr. Carter. Oh, he hasn't been welcomed back yet, so I'm still here, even after Miss Humphrey's diatribe. But, Max Naxim. Max is a local man of mystery and intrigue. Very local. 02025 local. I can't wait for Max to become international, a man of mystery, but he's not quite there yet. International just ain't Max's thing. He prefers to creatures' comforts of home, practicing yoga with his mother, playing the xylophone duets with his father, Googling esoteric alphabets with his cat. Never know. But not going to Chipotle, that's too stressful. And not doing homework, definitely not doing homework. Too dull. Max is too smart for homework, and we know he's too smart for any of the teachers to even bat an eye. Seriously, Max can do no wrong. Max can't even get in trouble on a school trip. Theoretically, if there was a school trip to, say, a random continent somewhere, Max couldn't get in trouble. Seriously, Max can do no wrong. Even if there was, theoretically, a championship parade where all the kids went, and Max wouldn't go. He couldn't get in trouble. But Max is chops on the stage. My boy can act. I know Max will sometimes be big time. We'll definitely be hearing about him down the road. When Max hears a call from Hollywood, he'll go to answer his phone, but his phone will be dead because he lent his charger to a friend. Seriously, Max, that's the guy we know. Ever the nice guy. Max would help out a friend and put aside his fabulous destiny of fame and future. On second thought, Max, just stick around and do it right here tonight. Thank you.
Please welcome Mr. Liam O'Connell, escorted by Sophie Matthews.
Yeah.
process, I read something that Liam wrote about himself. He listed himself as 5'8", which would make Mr. Sweeney 5'8" as well, and myself about 6 feet. Liam was in my chemistry class, and I know he's quite efficient at breaking things. He has an appetite for plastic. Chewing bottle caps is his gum. I suggest you don't swallow the bottle caps. They don't digest very well. I've also recently heard that Liam has been accepted to some very prestigious places, the Navy Academy, as well as West Point. I looked up the mascots for these schools. For the Navy, it's a goat. West Point, it is a mule. Let's take a poll. Is he a goat or a mule? These are very prestigious. This is a very prestigious selection, and I was a little bit concerned because I recall in class punctuality not being one of your strong points. This may have to change, or you'll be doing lots of push-ups. I think your arms may grow. Finally. At a recent visit to the Naval Academy, Liam reported it to me that he came back and he had mistakenly addressed a woman with a snappy, "Yes, sir." Good luck, Private Citizen Oki.
Next, please welcome to the stage Mr. Xander Schubert, escorted by Lily Estino.
Football, baseball standout Schubert. He's a legacy on the stage here. Makes me wonder if we'll see some origami tonight. Specially folded things seem to be important to the Schubert family. I already see one bow tie. Will there be one more in the audience? Xander, in physics class, is known as our cricket farmer. Whenever there's a question asked, all we hear is crickets. Xander enjoys the grueling efforts of growing his hair long in an effort to keep up with Coach A. Who's winning that, Xander? Xander also has an interesting reputation at the UN, the Model UN, thankfully, for creating imaginary countries. Government is definitely in your future. So this is our final contestant. To those of you who are about to compete, I salute you. To those of you who are about to witness this, I sympathize with you.
It is now time to test our contestants' intellectual capacity with a philosophical question. How smart are they? Are they quick on their feet? Or will they crack under pressure? The man who puts the psych in psychology, Mr. Chad Buckley!
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Good evening, contestants. Tonight's contestants will be called in a random order according to an algorithm written by the math department and approved by none other than Nick Schubert, Mr. Skipper, 2014, while working remotely in Vault 7. Each contestant will approach the podium, select a number from the dish, and the selected number determines the question that will shape the course of tonight's contest. So, without any further ado, Connor Curran.
How you doing tonight, Connor?
How's my hair?
All right, question number 9. We're gonna dust off a couple from previous years. You're standing in line at Chipotle, waiting for them to make your half steak, half carnitas burrito, and you look down and find $10 on the floor. The age-old moral dilemma. This is clearly not your money, but it would certainly pay for your meal. What kind of ethics do you have?
Well, I think anyone with the right mind would take those $10 and go to Cold Stone and get some ice cream.
All right, thank you, Connor. Next up, Kyle Ferreira. You think that's a 6? You want it to be a 6 or a 9? We just had number 9.
I want it to be.
All right, we'll go with 6.
6 it is.
You know, I really want to ask you, whose hair do you like better, mine or yours? But that's not the question. But you can answer that one while I look it up. Go ahead.
Well, if I had to choose, I would choose me because I have hair.
That's a much better question than number 6.
I thought it was 9.
Number 6, spell onomatopoeia. And give an example. You want the language of origin?
Yeah.
Okay, that's Greek.
Greek. I think Vinny's Greek. I would have to say A, skip a few A. And in context, I would use Mr. Savage, onomatopoeia.
All right, Kyle. Okay, number 3 on the list, Matias Loft. Number 10 it is. All right, Matias, if there were a dance move dedicated to you, what would it be called? An extra consideration if you demonstrate that move right now. What's the dance move? What would it be called?
This is really embarrassing, but I think I still love myself.
Okay, so it's the soil yourself dance move, and that's what it looks like. All right, next up. Derek Bennett. Well, thanks, Derek. How are you? You got $10 there for me? I thought you were going to give me a 10. All right, number 4.
Yeah.
You know what perseverance is, right?
Brave? I don't know.
You got some perseverance. You know, they call it grit today, you know? Yeah. You gotta be a little gritty.
You gotta get the inner grit.
Yeah, you gotta channel your inner grit. So tell us a time that you channeled your inner grit, and tonight does not count.
Well, I'd have to say, it's more of the shrimp and grit, you know?
Bubblegum shrimp and grits, all right, Derek. Thomas Durkin, your turn. All right, it's a 5. No mistaking that. All right, you know the common expression, I'm living the dream. What dream are you currently living?
Well, I'm in the crater, yeah. So as an ancient Chinese man once said, the ceiling is the roof. So my dream is whatever, finding out what that means.
All right, Thomas. All right, moving on, let's have that large baby come on up, Gavin. Mrs. Humphrey's a tough act to follow. That's smooth. That's the salt guy. Yeah, the Turkish salt guy. I like that.
All right, hit me, big guy. What we got?
All right. You know the President of the United States?
Yes.
You know his name?
Donald Trump.
Middle initial?
Nope.
If Mr. Donald Nope Trump were watching Mr. Skipper Pageant live right now, what would he tweet about you at 5 a.m.?
Can you repeat the question?
Just one more time, that's all I need.
Three branches of government?
Legislative, executive, judicial.
Awesome. President of the United States?
Donald Trump.
Middle initial?
Nope.
What would Mr. Donald Nope Trump tweet about you tomorrow after watching Mr. Skipper 2017?
He would tweet... He has very nice skin. Because he has like Cheeto skin, so it's like beautiful skin.
Huge, beautiful skin. All right, there you go, Gavin. Okey, come on up. I learned in kindergarten. What was your greatest takeaway there in the K room? And how do you use it today?
I'm gonna be completely honest, I didn't even hear that question. Oh my god. I can't do this. Goodbye.
Here, number 11. If you are lucky enough to be chosen as Mr. Skipper, how will you represent your school and what does the coveted rain suit mean to you?
That question is fake news.
All right, short and sweet. Mr. Cunningham. If they were making a movie about your life, what would the title be? Who would play you in the leading role and you can't choose Bobby Mayhill?
That is an interesting question, yes.
What? I'm sorry, I thought you said my name. I'm not Stalin. Why would you even suggest that I was stalling? No, come on, look, you're making things a little pressure here. There's a lot of pressure when you're making things tense right now. I'm just trying to come up with questions. Stop looking at me!
Oh my god, Mr. Buckley, do you have a thing for me?
This is so sudden!
Yeah, should ask you.
I could never. Oh my god, but surely you must know, they'll never accept our love. They'll never look at us the same way. But there's a part of me that says I don't care, because love finds a way. Love conquers all. Love has no barriers. Oh, kiss me, you fool! Jack. I'd be played by Hugh Jackman, who would star my life of everything that no one knows about me. Thank you.
All right, Xander, come on up, tough act to follow, pressure in the family, all that, I think he can do it. No, oh, look at that, he chose what number? Number one.
You look great tonight, Mr. Buckley, by the way.
Thank you very much. I like your glasses. How do you like mine?
Yeah, they're prescription.
Yeah. If you were stranded on a tropical island, what two things would you want with you and why?
I'd probably have to say two judges, Miss Almeida and Mrs. Norton.
Smooth, smooth, smooth. All right, Matt. You want to go random or do you want to go with seven?
I'm going to take seven.
You're going to take seven, okay.
Seven is my favorite letter.
Okay, you got to think about people.
I love people.
People. Some can be alive, some can be dead.
Yeah.
Just got to think about people. Famous people. And if you could have dinner with one of those famous people, who would you invite and why? And what would you eat?
Oh, boy. You know, if I really had to choose, it'd probably be the great, great oblique tips of, Guy Fieri. Because, I think he brings a flavor to the whole thing. And, he's actually my dad.
And he's got great hair, too. All right, ladies and gentlemen, that wraps it up. The philosophy competition is over. And let's give these guys a great round of applause.
Bring honor to my family.
I'm here so that Xander doesn't win.
I'm just here so Gavin doesn't win.
Because I got fun coupons.
Well, I plan on peaking in high school, so if I win Mr. Skipper, everything from there is going to be downhill.
Asking that's like, why do birds fly and why do fish swim? Because the universe demands it.
Because my parents moved me to this country specifically to win this competition and eat Big Macs, and I'm all out of Big Macs.
Get pucks deep, aggressive forecheck, pucks on net, and score a couple Genos. I think we'll come out with the W, eh? Back on my
feet, just a man. Because according to all known laws of aviation, bees should not be able to fly. Its wings are too small to get its fat little body off the ground. But of course, bees fly anyway, because bees do not care what humans think.
Don't lose your grip. Well, Max stole it from me last year. I'm here to reclaim what's rightfully mine.
Well, I joined the competition in the first place to impress that special other, Derek Bennett, Dare Bear.
Lumberjack and I'm okay.
Please welcome Jack Cunningham.
Jack, and he's okay. He shoots all
Jack Hambone Cunningham stands a proud 5'6". He can be seen in front of the camera, behind the camera, next to the camera, and holding the camera. Good thing this boy has a face for radio. Jack, 1-4-3, TV. Standing at a solid 6 feet, please welcome Matias Lofty Loft. Matias loves finger puppets and Swedish meatballs. When not on the soccer field, Matias volunteers his time at IKEA, alphabetizing the storage bins and translating the directions. Matias Loft. Good thing he just finished learning his talent last night. Is this troubling? Not really. Kyle might just be the most prepared to enter the competition. Please welcome Mr. Patrick P. Hags Haggerty. At 5'10", he doesn't want to be left on Hags Island. Hey, ladies and gentlemen, Patrick Haggerty. Please welcome Liam Oki O'Connell. Liam holds his head high as 5'8". He's an avid bottle cap chewer and can throw a soccer ball on natural distances. Oki, give us a thumbs up if you're having fun. Okie dokie. Please welcome Mr. Xander Shuby Schubert. And I'm glad that Mr. Schubert was born one of Mr. Skipper champions. It's a little known fact that Xander actually coined the phrase Google, and Coach A pays him to see every time he shouts it. Like you know that ladies love the many. Mr. Xander Schubert. Put your hands together for Thomas Durkatroy Durkin. And 5'10", this lucky leprechaun is related to everyone in the town of Cohasset. He's hoping to have the luck of the Irish on his side, because as he says, they're always after me lucky charms. Thomas Durkin. At a solid 7 feet, or so he thinks, Gavin Dinkelberg Doubleburger. You know what, Gavin, that's all the intro you get. That was a mouthful. Not least, the strapping 5'10", Connor, the anti-swag current, loves stamp collecting, local newspaper publications, and making new friends. Hey, Connor, you were born in Singapore. Are they talented? You be the judge. Ladies and gentlemen, our talents competition. Please put your hands together for Mr. Jack Cunningham.
Hello all, I hope you're enjoying the show.
show as much as I am, and if not, well, there's the door. I want to take a moment and kind of discuss all the importance of the Mr. Skipper fundraiser. Now, obviously I can't do this by myself, so I've decided to have a guest there up on screen to help me discuss this. Please welcome me! Of course he's late. He's always late.
Hello, Cohasset!
And of course, all you single ladies out there. So, Jack, why don't you tell us a little about why we love Mr. Skipper?
Well, as you know, it's a night of spectacle, majesty, and of course, romance.
What are you doing?
You know, I'm revealing a more romantic side.
Well, stop.
Okay, come on. You don't want me single forever. You need a girlfriend, bro. And what a better wingman than me?
No, we're not using Mr. Skipper as a way to pick up chicks.
Okay, look, there's no better time to woo a girl than when she's a captive audience.
What?
Boy, that came out wrong. What I mean is, all I'm saying is, look, when a girl has no feasible way to escape,
stop.
She kinda has to listen to what you're saying, right?
Please stop talking.
Right, okay, let's start. Hey, ladies. Special someone to take away all the stress in your life. Have you got a color with me? Well, I got the perfect guy right here. Mystery man of your dreams, Jason.
Johnny Cash?
Not quite, but someone just as special. So dial this number here for a
minute.
Get that number! Las chicas de Puerto Rico. You need to mock yourself, player.
No, I'm not looking for a girlfriend. I don't want a girlfriend. I just want to give a good performance.
Don't lie to yourself, Jack. No one knows you better than me. You're hoping a girl will see you on stage and find you dreaming.
Enough! You're so frustrating! Wipe that stupid look off your face, you moron!
Hey, I'd have to take that from you.
I'm going to hurt you.
Oh, so now you're a masochist.
No, look, I'm trying to give a good performance and you're screwing this up. Okay?
You know what? I'm taking over.
You can't do that. Who do you think you are?
You?
Me?
Us?
So I am you and you are me?
But if we is me, then who is he?
What?
Who?
Look, you know, I wrote you a script, so please, just read off of it.
But it's so boring.
Well, it's family friendly, and it doesn't have anything to do with me getting a girlfriend. So read it.
I really hate myself sometimes.
Don't I know it. So, Jack, why do we love Mr. Skipper?
Oh, wow. It's such a wonderful night. I think it's just a wonderful fundraiser for senior prom.
It sure is. Hey, who would you want to win?
Oh, well, gee, I don't know. I sure can't decide. Everyone's so talented, they all deserve the time. You don't care about the other contestants.
I think we all deserve a shot.
No, you don't. You're still furious about how you lost last year.
I did
all
win
the- is that the judges will let you win this year.
Shut up! I did win the talent portion!
Oh, I won the talent portion next year. Yeah, I bet you won't even win that this year.
No thanks to you!
Oh, come on. I'm the only one who's actually trying to make this show semi-decent. Not like you could ever do that.
That's it.
Jack? I can't do the show with just me. I need myself. Hey.
I'm sorry for hitting you.
Don't mention it.
We all deserve a little self-flagellation from time to time.
But you wanna know something, bud?
What?
Before you can start loving others, you gotta love yourself.
I do love myself. It's just, sometimes I get so confused and don't know who I am.
Hey, it's like our favorite philosopher, Bob Marley, once said.
Don't worry, be happy now.
Yeah, I am happy. Well, thanks for being here with me, at least.
Ah, don't mention it. And remember, ladies, if you're looking for a good time tonight, this is going to be right for you.
Easy game. Truth or dare, I think you know it, but
What is your favorite anti-drug campaign, Truth or Dare?
I'm gonna go Truth on that one.
Truth? That's correct. Yes. Alright. Now we're gonna play another game. Similar. It's called Ruth or Claire. I'm gonna show you a picture of an elderly woman. 75 plus here, guys. And you have to tell me if her name is Ruth or Claire.
Claire.
That is also correct. You're pretty good at this. Alright. Another game. Booth or Flair. I'm gonna tell you a situation, and you have to tell me if it's John Wilkes Booth or Rick Nature Boy Flair. Which one of these men broke his ankle jumping off a building at a sold-out show? John Wilkes Booth? We're actually gonna accept both on that one. Yeah. Three for three. All right, we're gonna play one last game here, guys. I'm gonna show you a picture of a house. Just normal house. And you have to tell me if it's in Duluth, Minnesota, or St. Clair, Michigan. Duluth or St. Clair?
Gonna have to go with Duluth on that one.
Duluth. It's actually Yakima, Washington. Thank you for playing.
Please welcome to the stage, Derek Bennett.
Three of us, and now the tallest will go in the middle.
The whole dance will be backwards. I'm always on your left.
And right now you're getting on my last nerve. Switch.
And finally, please welcome to the stage, Santa's Helper is doing Jingle Bell Rock.
Thank you.
Hello, and welcome back to another episode of Teacher Jeopardy. I'm your host, Alex Trebek. For those who were watching before the break, I would just like to apologize to anyone who's from Hull. We promise that the contestants will refrain from making any more statements like that. Before the break, we left you with a new Jeopardy record, as Mr. Savage, representing the science department, trails with negative $10,000. Just ahead of him is Mr. Welch, who represents the economics department, trails at negative $2,000.
Guys.
And Coach A, who is representing the history department in a commanding lead of $34. Let's see the categories for Double Jeopardy. And we have potent potables, who's that teacher, historical F art pieces, these are works of art that begin in the letter F, words that rhyme with dog, 13th century Russian history, and previous black presidents. That's gonna be the contestants. Mr. Welch, I'll start with you. On my card here, it says that you are an avid snowmobiler.
That's right, Trebek. There is nothing like cruising through the mountains of New Hampshire thinking about the opportunity cost of creating my own smelter factory.
Terrific. All right, Coach Ed. It says here on my card that you were once loosely linked to the disappearances of four people in northern Siberia 25 years ago. Do you have anything to comment about that?
Nobody, no problem.
Right you are, Coach. And lastly, Mr. Savage. On my card here, it says that you once bought a $40 hole puncher on Amazon. Care to comment?
All I need to say is I wish I was a little brother Mr. Sasso never had, and I'm dressed like a father of five.
Truly outstanding. Okay, Coach Ed, you're in command of the board, so pick a category.
Yeah, I would like 13th century Russian history for 400, Trebek.
The Russian holiday, Dedoshvina, has been celebrated on Saturday for who? Yes, Coach Ed.
What are the boys?
No, that is incorrect. Saturdays are not for the boys. The correct answer is military veterans.
No, it's not.
Yes, it is.
No, it's not.
Okay. Sadly, Coach A, you're still in the lead, so pick again.
Let's see. I'd like, who's that teacher for 1200? Go blue.
This former staff member was an avid blogger on her self-made H2O website. Mr. Savage.
Who is Mrs. Drinkwater?
That is correct. Mike, pick a category.
Yeah, I'll take historical farts for 400.
Did you just say historical farts? Are you kidding me? That says historical F art pieces. I think you did that on purpose.
Nope.
What's going on here?
Hey, Trebek, when was the last time you were in the weight room?
Well, I guess a couple of days. Wait, I don't need to answer to you. Yes, this is
any serious gains?
Guys, why are we talking about something other than economics right now? I just don't understand why.
Contestants, please only use the buzzer for Jeopardy-related questions, not personal questions about my life. You know what? I'm gonna pick a category. How about we try what rhymes with dog for 800? Our very own weather bug here at CHS is triggered by thunderstorms and what? Mr. Welch.
Grokking, of course. Thank you very much. I'll take 13th Russian history for 800, Trebek.
No, that is incorrect, and you must answer in the form of a question.
What is grokking?
No, you are still incorrect. The correct response was, what is thick fog?
thick fog. Okay, Coach A, you're still in the lead, so I'll go back to you.
Yeah, I'll take, who's that teacher for? 400? Go blue.
Whenever you're confused in my class, I make sure you know that you are a...
Coach A.
What are our current events? What's going on in the world?
No, that is incorrect. Mr. Welch.
What is a smart student?
That is correct. Mr. Welch, pick a category. He was our previous black president. Yes, Mr. Savage.
What is thick fog?
No, we've already moved on from that question. The answer was, who is Barack Obama? Well, we'll go, you know what? All right, let's just forget about the rest and go to Final Jeopardy, how about? The question, what school do you teach at? 30 seconds. Mr. Welch, we come to you first. The question was, where do you teach? And you answered, Weymouth High School, and you wagered the Consumer Price Index.
Hey, I just want to be fair, okay? It's all about being fair.
Absolutely. Coach A, it appears you have smashed your board, so you are disqualified. And lastly, we go to you, Mr. Savage. The question, what school do you teach at? And he answered, Sadie, the name of his dog. And he wagered a picture of a sea turtle. Well, thankfully, we're all out of time. So please, catch us on another episode of Teacher Jeopardy. Thank you and good night.
Unique New York.
unique New York. You never know. You never, never ever know when you need your vocal cords. It was really nice out today.
Welcome to the stage, Max Nakashima.
And now, I would like to present the Russian alphabet. A is for A's. B is for bubbles. C is for sizzle. D is for don't even get me started. E is for in Michael Jackson auditorium. F is for if I fall in love, it will be forever. G is for jiggle. Jiggle. G is for Gibbler. Kimmy. H is for Hi Chica. I is for Igor. J is for Juicy Juice. K is for K-Swiss. L is for Loop-de-loop. M is for Mama said knock you out. N is for Anastasia. O is for oh snap. P is for Q is for cube. R is for Rubik's. S is for psych you out. T is for torn. I am torn between the two G's. G is for jiggle and G for gibbler. I do not know which I like best, therefore I am T for torn. U is for oof dollar toes. It's supposed to sound like half dollar toes, but is U for oof, so it sounds like oof dollar toes. V is for please make me Mr. Skipper. W is for double dutch bumper up. X is for Mr. Sears. Y is for Niet. And Z is for Zoogly Zoo. Thank you.
So that's when you just bust out the GOP scroll.
Those are my favorite.
And now they're made with 20% more real cheese.
Awesome.
Plus, it's way better than what she usually makes.
Hey! I am your mother! Thank you.
Please welcome Thomas Durkin.
Hi, my name is Thomas Durkin, and these are my impressions. So let me tell you a little story about my weekend. So I was up north to Saskatchewan hunting caribou with my nephew Otto. Next thing I know, park ranger comes up and starts giving me the business. He said, sir, crap, I forgot my line. He said, sir, He said, sir, I saw you and Otto there stalking about 25 caribou in your car. Now I'm here to tell you that you can't do that because the legal limit around here is 2, all right? So I said, all right, listen up, big shoots, because I'm only going to explain this once, all right? You can, crap. All right, I can't even do this one. Literally just go to the next one, will you?
Oh, hello, I'm Wade Goodman, owner, operator, and founder of Globo Gym America. I just want to tell you that you're not stoked with what you got. Of course, it'll still be you in a legal sense, but think of it as a thinner, more attractive, better you than you could have ever become without us. How do I know? Well, I'm not only the founder of Globo Gym. 6 years and 600 pounds ago, I was also a client. You go to the next one, yeah.
Hi, my name is Sammy Bagel Jr., and I just want to be friends with all of you. I mean, I'm a pacifist, and the only thing I've ever pushed was my peaceful agenda, and even that I didn't even really push. More passive-aggressively nudged.
Good evening, my fellow Americans. In November, the country voted for a new president. Now, in November, the country voted for a new president. The American people have spoken, and many agree that the country would be better off in the hands of a man with the skin tone of an Oompa Loompa. And more bleach in his hair than Kyle Ferrer when he entered the tournament at Sacred Heart. Now, let me assure you, if Donald Trump succeeds, we all succeed. On behalf of myself, Sasha, Malia, and Michelle, I just want to say thanks, America. It's been real. It's been good. But it ain't been real good.
All right, you know what? Hey, go back to the Canadian one. I'll try that again. All right. Hey, Saskatchewan, eh? All right, no. Ready? Let me tell you a little story about my weekend. So I was up north hunting the caribou and with my nephew Otto in Saskatchewan. Jesus. Park ranger comes up and starts giving me the business. He said, sir, I got some calls from some disgruntled neighbors about some possible hunting violations. Says they saw you and Otto here stalking about 25 caribou in your car. Now I'm here to inform you that you can't do that because the legal limit around here is 2. Care to explain? So I said, all right, listen up, big shoots, because I'm only going to explain this once. All right, Otto here is a good shot, okay? He had a good hunt. So you can't come up here smoking darts making allegations about caribou. Oh, how'd you get 25 anyway? I said, well, big shoots, when you're using a rifle, I assume it would be pretty easy, but when you're using grenades, it becomes quite simple. And that's it, that's all.
Right now, for formal wear, your winner is Patrick Haggerty.
fascinating answer to the question was Mr. Jack Cunningham. For signature wear, he had the luck of the Irish on his side, Mr. Thomas Durbin. Talent competition was won by the trio of Dunkelberger, Schubert, and Curran. You voted a lot, and your audience vote went to Mr. Xander Schubert. Gentleman who will wear the coveted skipper suit, Mr. Max Nakashima!
To last throughout the years.